ബെൽറ്റു.
ഹലോ മൈ ഡിയർ ചിൽഡ്രൻ, വെൽക്കം ബാക്ക്. ഇംഗ്ലീഷ് ടൈം ഈസ് ബ്ലൂമിംഗ് ഹിയർ. ചിൽഡ്രൻ, ഡു യു റിമെമ്പർ ആർ ലാസ്റ്റ് ക്ലാസ് അസൈൻമെന്റ്സ്? ലെറ്റ് അസ് ഗോ ത്രൂ സം സാമ്പിൾസ്.
There was an ape in a zoo who always sang boo boo. It thought it was a poet, so it never kept quiet. It made the cuckoo go coo. It made the cuckoo go coo.
Wonderful bird is peacock. He dances around a rock. He watches an incident. It is an accident. Our national bird is peacock.
A wonderful bird is the pelican. His bill holds more than his belly can. He can take in his beak enough food for a week. But I'm damned if I see how the helican.
There was an old man with a beard. He sat on the grass and heard the sound of a flowing river. It was a beautiful weather. He heard the sound of a coat.
There was an old man on a hill who sat down if I was to stare. He ran up and down in his grandmother's ground. He ran up and down in his grandmother's gown, which adorned that old man on here. There was an old man on a hill who said to me, if I was to stare. He ran up and down in his grandmother's gown, which adorned that the old man on the hill.
How are you? Do you feel stressed at home? How can we feel relaxed when sitting at home? Any idea? Draw pictures. Write stories and poems. Some of you might be interested in making models and crafts. You could do all these things. Shall I suggest something to feel relaxed at home? Music. Listening to music gives you much relaxation. It can pacify our mind, alter our mood. Nowadays, you are getting much time to listen, read, and write stories, and even to sleep. Am I correct? Okay. Why do we like stories? Certain stories help us learn some important lessons in our life. The stories from Panchatantra and Aesop's fables are some of such stories. Children, tell me, what do you like the most? Songs or stories? Good. You like both, right? Is there anybody who doesn't love music? Not only children, but elders also like stories and songs and music. Why do we like music? Any idea? What effect does it have on us? We like music because it makes us feel good, right? K. Music soothes our mind. Sometimes it reduces our tension and makes us happy, right? Okay. We have great singers and musicians in Malayalam, right? Can you name some of them? Of course, yes. Aaron Ganagandharvan, Sri K.J. Yeshudas, M.G. Srikumar, M.S. Subbalakshmi, S. Janaki, K.S. Chitra, and great musicians like M. Jayachandran, Ausipachan sir, etc. Recently, one famous South Indian singer died. Who is that? Yes, S.P. Balasubramanian, who sang more than 40,000 songs in 16 different languages. Music has a charm to soothe our minds. It touches our body, mind, soul, and calms our behavior and provides relief from stress. ശ്രവണ സുന്ദരങ്ങളായ ശബ്ദങ്ങൾ കൊണ്ട് മനസ്സിൽ വികാരങ്ങൾ സൃഷ്ടിച്ച് രസിപ്പിക്കുന്ന ഒരു കലയാണ് സംഗീതം. രാഗ താള പദാശ്രയമായതാണ് സംഗീതം എന്നാണ് സംഗീതത്തെക്കുറിച്ച് പറയുന്നത്. അക്ഷരങ്ങളുടെയും വാക്കുകളുടെയും സഹായത്തോടെ ആശയവിനിമയം നടത്തുന്നത് സാഹിത്യഭാഷയെങ്കിൽ സ്വരങ്ങളുടെ സഹായത്തോടെ ആശയപ്രകടനം നടത്തുന്ന നാദഭാഷയാണ് സംഗീതം. വികാരങ്ങളുടെ ഭാഷയാണ് സംഗീതം. മനുഷ്യൻ്റെ സകല വികാരങ്ങളെയും ദുഃഖത്തെയും സംഘർഷങ്ങളെയും സംഗീതത്തിൽ കൂടി ആവിഷ്കരിക്കുവാൻ സാധിക്കും. ഇത് മനുഷ്യന് ശാന്തിയും സമാധാനവും കൈവരുത്തുന്നു. മൈ ഡിയേഴ്സ്, ക്യാൻ യു നെയിം സം ഫേമസ് മ്യൂസിഷ്യൻസ്? വാച്ച് ദിസ് വീഡിയോ, യു ക്യാൻ സീ സം ഫേമസ് മ്യൂസിഷ്യൻസ് ആൻഡ് സിംഗേഴ്സ് ഹിയർ.
A.R. Rahman is the most popular name in the Indian music industry. His real name is A.S. Dilip Kumar and professionally adopted the name A.R. Rahman. He won 2 Oscar awards for the original background music and also for the song Jai Ho in the movie The Slumdog Millionaire. 2 Grammy awards, 6 National Film Awards for Music, and almost 15 Filmfare Awards were also won by him. He started his music composition at a very young age. He is also a great keyboard and guitar player. He was born in Kerala and later settled in Tamil Nadu. He became so famous in India as a musician, where his name is so popular even among the children in every household.
Michael Joseph Jackson, the most popular singer in the world, was born in the year 1958 in America. He is considered to be the king of pop music. He is not only a famous singer known to the whole world, but also used to write songs. Jackson is regarded as one of the most significant artistic figures of the 20th century. He is a great dance performer in his stage shows. His shows were not only popular in America and Europe, but also in Asian countries. He is the most awarded artist in the history of popular music. Days before, people used to reach the venue where Jackson is supposed to perform. Most youngsters used to dance and sing with him in a historical manner during his stage shows. When he turned to 50, at the height of his popularity, he died in the year 2000.
Do you know, in ancient times too, there were great kings who were great lovers of music. Shall we see some kings who were very fond of music? This picture. What do you see here? Yes, this is the court of a great emperor who was an ardent worshipper of music. Can you guess his name? Yes, the great emperor of Hindustan. Yes, the great King Akbar. My dear children, now I am inviting you all to the court of the mighty Emperor Akbar. Come on, let's see what's happening there. Come on.
Re ma ga re sa re ni sa re ni sa ni da sa ni da ma pa re ga re ma ga re sa re ni sa a da ga ga re re ga re ma ga re sa re ni sa re ni sa ni da sa ni da ma pa re ga re ma ga re sa re ni sa a re ga re ma ga re sa re ni sa.
Wonderful, Tanzan. Superb. I listen to you every day, but I can't seem to have enough. I think you have the most wonderful voice in the world.
But I don't, Shahenshah. There is someone who sings far better than I do.
Really? Then I must have him sing in my court. Can you arrange it?
I am afraid he will not come, sir.
What? Not even if he hears that the emperor himself summoned him?
No, not even then.
Very well, Ustad. If he doesn't come, I shall go to him myself. Will you take me to him?
Yes, sure. Provided you don't come as an emperor of Hindustan.
I shall go as a humble lover of music.
Children, hope you have enjoyed the video, don't you? Can you identify the musical instrument in this story? Yes, you can tell that. Try. Yeah, you're right. Yes, it's a tanbura or tamburu. Here, I will introduce you some antique musical instruments of Kerala.
Thank you.
tell me, which event in Kerala is associated with this instrument? Yeah, come on, try, you can say. Yes, exactly, Thrissur Puram. These are our traditional musical instruments. There are other musical instruments too. Singers and some may like musicians. Okay, that's up to you. Children, look at page 59 of your textbook. Identify the person who plays the musical instrument. This is your first task. Okay, you may send answer to your teacher, right?
Akbar, the Mughal Emperor, is popularly known as Akbar the Great. He restructured the Mughal army and expanded his kingdom. He was very fond of music from his early years. Akbar himself was a learned musician. His interest in music led to the progress of both instrumental and vocal music in India. He belonged to the 16th century. There were 36 musicians of high grade in Akbar's court. Akbar was a true lover of music. Great musicians like Tansen, Baba Ramdas, Sundar Das, etc. adorned his court. Akbar took active interest in other religions also. His court was said to be a center of the then Indian culture. Akbar died in the year 1605 at the age of 63.
മുഗൾ സാമ്രാജ്യത്തിൻ്റെ മൂന്നാമത്തെ ചക്രവർത്തിയാണ് ജലാലുദ്ദീൻ മുഹമ്മദ് അക്ബർ. മഹാനായ അക്ബർ എന്നും അറിയപ്പെടുന്നു. ചക്രവർത്തി ഹുമയൂണിൻ്റെ പുത്രനായിരുന്ന അക്ബർ തൻ്റെ പിതാവിനെ തുടർന്ന് 1556 മുതൽ 1605 വരെ അദ്ദേഹം സാമ്രാജ്യം ഭരിച്ചു. അക്ബറിന് മുൻപുള്ള ബാബർ, ഹുമയൂൺ എന്നീ ചക്രവർത്തിമാർക്ക് യുദ്ധങ്ങൾ നടത്തി മാത്രമേ സാമ്രാജ്യം സ്ഥാപിക്കുവാൻ സാധിച്ചിട്ടുള്ളൂ. എന്നാൽ സാമ്രാജ്യത്തിൽ ശക്തമായ ഒരു ഭരണക്രമം സ്ഥാപിച്ചത് അക്ബറാണ്. അതുകൊണ്ട് മുഗൾ സാമ്രാജ്യത്തിൻ്റെ മഹാശില്പി എന്നാണ് അക്ബറെ അറിയപ്പെട്ടിരുന്നത്. അക്ബറിൻ്റെ കാലത്താണ് മുഗൾ സാമ്രാജ്യം അതിൻ്റെ പരമോന്നതിയിൽ എത്തിയത്. സംഗീത തൽപരനായിരുന്ന ഇദ്ദേഹം ബസ് ബഹദൂർ, താൻസൻ എന്നിവരുൾപ്പെടെ 36 സംഗീതജ്ഞരെ പ്രോത്സാഹിപ്പിച്ചിരുന്നു. Now, I shall read that part. Okay? What will you do? Read along with me. The text will be seen on the screen. Okay? The Song of Songs. Slowly, gently, the exhausted musician laid his tanpura on the carpet. The exquisite strains of Rag Darbari still vibrated within the hall. Emperor Akbar looked up, his eyes lit with admiration. "Wonderful," he said. "Superb. I listen to you every day, but I can't seem to have enough." Tansen, the musician, bowed in silent gratitude. "I think you have the most wonderful voice in the world," said Akbar. "But I don't, Shahenshah," said Tansen with a smile. "There is someone who sings far better than I do." "Really?" cried the disbelieving Akbar. "Then I must have him sing in my court. Can you arrange it?" Tansen shook his head. "I'm afraid he will not come, sir." "What? Not even if he hears that the emperor himself summoned him?" "No, not even then." This reply would have enraged any other emperor, but Akbar was different. "Very well, Ustadji," said Akbar, smiling into Tansen's half-scared eyes. "If he doesn't come, I shall go to him myself. Will you take me to him?" "Yes, sir, provided you do not come as the emperor of Hindustan. I shall go as a humble lover of music." My dear children, let me ask you some simple questions. Are you ready? Who are the characters here? Yes, you are correct. Emperor Akbar and Tansen. Who is Tansen? Tansen is the royal musician in Emperor Akbar's court. What quality of Tansen is revealed when he says, "There is someone who sings far better than I do"? Yes, it shows Tansen's humility or humbleness. He was one of the greatest Hindustani classical singers in India. His music has always charmed and inspired millions. Now, shall I give you an activity? Look at page number 56 and 57. Some excerpts about two popular musicians are given there. One in the form of a memo and other in the form of a profile. Listen if the author himself has written the excerpt. It is his memo. And when someone writes about others, it's a profile. Now, rewrite the memo of Michael Jackson in the profile and imagine that you are A.R. Rahman. Rewrite the profile in the memo. Write them in your notebook. Your teacher will give you more assistance. Okay? Now watch the last part of the act again.
Very well, Ustad. If he doesn't come, I shall go to him myself. Will you take me to him?
Yes, sure. Provided you don't come as an emperor of Hindustan.
I shall go as a humble lover of music.
Who might be the man? Why was the man not able to be summoned to the court of Akbar? Read the old story and find out answers to my questions. Okay, you may read the story. What is the title? Yeah, The Song of Songs. Read the story well. Read as many times possible. Write the main events of the story in your notebook. Okay, we'll continue the story in the next class. Till then, bye-bye.